Okay guys, so you have installed Python, you have configured Python, everything is working. You can check the Python is working now. You might be knowing about different kinds of packages available in the Python, or if you don't know about different kinds of packages available in Python, then I would recommend to go on Python website and check out the list of the supporting packages available. Package is nothing but a specific for doing a specific task. You need to install set of files. You don't have to individually install all the files, but it's a package name. You write a package name. For example, you want to access a CSV file in Python. So in that case, you don't have to install any module, since CSV file is available with the base version of Python. So what we will do, we will get to know a new term called pip. Pip is a Python package manager, so it will basically install Python modules onto your system so that it can be used by Python base file. So in order to get the list of pip installed in your system, you can choose pip and then say list. So it will give you a list of all the packages installed. Okay, now here what we have, since we have installed this Python out of the box from the program, from website, so what it does, it has a lower version of pip module. The version of pip is 10.0.1, however this new version is available, 19.1.1. so what we can do, as mentioned here, we can write Python m pip install, install and --/ upgrade pip. So this will upgrade the pip itself. So it's a package manager which has a low older version, so it will upgrade the pip and it will install a new pip. So congratulations, we have a new pip installed. Now we can go to pip list, so we can find out the list of things available. So as of now, we can see there are only pip and setup tools are available here. So what we'll do, we'll install some of the packages from a Python library. So how you can do that, we'll see it. Okay, so for example, we need to install a package called OpenPyXL. So it's a very popular Python modules package, we can say. So this is very important and useful in operating with Excel file. Basically, you can read and write Excel using Python. So in order to install it, we can go to OpenPyXL. You can search in OpenPyXL Python. It'll give you OpenPyXL PyPI. So if you click on the link, it will open here and it will say a command, pip install OpenPyXL. So what we will do, we will write the same here. So pip install OpenPyXL. So it should start collecting the data, and you don't have to worry about the version, because what it does, when you write a command, open install OpenPyXL, pip install OpenPyXL, it basically search into the directory which is defined by Python, which is organized by python.org, and say, and then pull out the latest version based on the version installed on your system. For example, somebody is using on Python 2, or maybe somebody is working on Python 3, they have to write the same command, pip install OpenPyXL. The respective package will be downloaded and installed in your system. There's a little bit of difference between pip 2 and pip 3. So for example, I'm writing pip here because I have only one version of Python installed in my system, so it will recognize pip. If specific, I have to go write, for example, I have Python 2 and Python 3 installed in my system. So if I write pip, it by default, it will, so there is a default setting, so that particular pip will execute. So if I want a list of modules installed in Python 2, then we have to specifically mention pip 2. Since I have Python 3 installed in my system, so even if I write pip or pip 3, both are same. I hope you understand. So if I write pip 3 and list, Now we can check. It will show these tools. So initially we can see there are only pip and setup tools were available. Now see, after installing this one, we have this files available on our system. So this is how we can install a library or you can say a package modules from external website using pip command. So similarly, suppose we want to install another package, just to show an example of one more package so that it's very clear to you all guys. What we'll do, we'll install a very popular package from Python library that's mostly used in numerical computation. It's called NumPy. So what we'll do, we'll go to the same website and here we'll write NumPy. So when we write NumPy, we have a lot of lists. So we go to 1.16.3, it's the latest one. So we see, we have a list, pip install NumPy. So what we'll do, either we can copy it from here or and paste it here, or we can directly write pip install numpy. Here you can also write pip3 install numpy, it'll work same way. So it is collecting numpy and in a short while it will be installed. So here we go. So it has been installed. Now we can check with the pip list. So you can see NumPy is available here, 1.16.3. So this is the way we will be installing, or you can install all the packages that you need for your applications. So there are a wide variety of packages available. You can go through this website and find out the list of packages available here. So this is specific to NumPy. So there are a lot of resources available on the internet where you can find out the list of packages. For example, if you go to this pypi.org, you can find, you can search anything related to your requirement, and then you can find out all this list. There's a very beautiful tutorial of how to install py packages, like installing and packages. There's a very beautiful tutorials by this Python community. So it has mentioned everything. If you find some kind of error or something, it's a very good place to get the solutions for your problem. I hope it is clear and it makes some sense. If you have any question, any doubt regarding installing Python or working with Python basic setup, this is purely a beginner tutorial, so my intention is to get all the details available to you, all necessary informations in case, because I'll be thinking in my perspective through my own mindset. In case I skip something, you can put your comments in the comment section and I'll be very happy to help you on that, and will definitely try to answer all your questions. Thank you so much and hope to see you in the next tutorial.